and it kind of smells funky, but like me sometimes. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. Today another Let's Talk Makeup New Makeup Releases, where I go over new makeup releases, sneak peeks, and give you my opinion. Yes. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And besides talking about makeup, I really love applying makeup as well, especially colorful makeup. And I feel very, very nice and summery today, even though I'm still a bit cold. Yes, because apparently here in the Netherlands, we are a little bit in autumn almost, but that's neither here nor there now, is it? If you love color just as much as I do, or maybe you just want to get into color, or you are older and you want to know how to best apply everything on a skin that is a little bit more movable in certain places, then make sure that you are subscribed, because we can figure everything out together. Yes, that is it today. I did film the makeup look. I had a lot of fun filming this makeup look. I'm really into the two-toned looks this week. I filmed this with the box there, Kaleidos stuff. It's kind of a get ready style video, and I think it is coming next week, but I am not completely sure. Yes, without further ado, let's just get into it. Let me grab something that I'm going to talk about, because I have it here and I have some stuff on the way. And yeah, so let me go to the side, open up my Instagram, and start with VE Cosmetics, the Blood Moon Palette. You guys have been pestering me, when can we see it, when can we see it? And I already knew it, because I already had it in house. I got this palette SPR, and here she is. So this is the front. And so, so cool. It's an all matte palette. I have also a video online already that went online last Wednesday when the palette released. And this is the color story. She's an all matte palette. And if you want to see how she performs and my looks that I created with it, I will link the video underneath the cards. And if I have room, it is also in the description box, but it will be underneath the cards regardless. This is... It's such a good spoiler alert. It's such a good palette. Now, when the palette released last Wednesday, she had a sale. I don't know if the sale is still in effect, but if it isn't, I do have a code with her that you will save you 10% in case you want to order this palette. And honestly, you should. Yeah, what can I'm not biased at all. Well, I kind of am a little. It's just such a good palette, guys. I had so much fun creating the looks. Even though I'm not really into all matte looks usually, this palette made it so effortlessly. Made it so effortless. Yes, that's correct grammar, right? It made it effortless. The palette is live and I will link it. Oh yeah, but I do have an update, because some of you asked if it was a permanent in her collection, and it is. However, I do need to make sure that I say it correctly, because there is problems shipping. So let's see, not specifically that, at the end of June, Europe is, the EU is basically being, they want to tax us on everything that we order outside of the EU, and the UK is outside of the EU because of Brexit. So what is she doing? She has to figure stuff out, how it will go with taxes and all that. And they are able to be, there is a way for us to order from overseas brands, then they can include the taxes and all that for us, but that is a thing, and she's trying to figure that out. So she says here, it is permanent, but she is stopping shipping to Europe on June the 20th for a while she works away around the new Brexit / VAT issues. So if you want this palette or anything else from VE Cosmetics, basically now is the time. If you are in Europe, because after the 20th, the rules will change, and she needs to figure out how to best go about that. Just an FYI. Yeah, that's it. So if you want to order from her and you are in Europe, basically now is the time. Or in the EU, now is the time. And otherwise, yeah, we'll just have to wait a little bit while she can see how she can accommodate us as well, you know? It's just an entire, as if we don't pay enough money in the EU already. But that's neither here nor there. There's nothing really I can do about it, unfortunately. Okay, let's go to the next thing, which is a sneak peek from Made by Mitchell. And as I'm filming this on Thursday, I don't know. I'm guessing it is either dropping today as you are seeing this on the 28th, or it is being shown on the 28th. All I know is that something big is coming, and I have no idea what. So, yeah, if I know by the time I'm done editing, I will put in pictures or maybe film a separate piece. But I have no idea. I know that something is coming. So, yeah, that's it. Let me know if you are excited. Made by Mitchell is a UK-based brand. They are available at Beauty Bay. They are also available at Boozy Shop. I think that's it. Let me know if you are excited. I'm curious to see what he will release. I'm very, very curious. Let's go next to Glam Shop Poland, because they have a new collaboration and they have some newness. So the collaboration is with, her name is Marta Parciak. I hope that I pronounced that correctly. She has a YouTube channel. She has her own company as well. And well, she has collabed with Glam Shop Poland. They came out with two palettes and a few eye pencils. So one palette is an all shimmer palette. And then the other one is an all matte palette. The Ulubieńczy, which means favorite, is an all matte palette. And then the other one, which is called Perse... No, I don't know how to pronounce that. Perche. Blisk. Perche Blisk. I hope. Which is translates as flash. It's an all shimmer finish palette. And you also get liners. A blue one, a purple one, and a black one or a brown one. One of the two. Let's see. I don't know. But yeah, it looks very, very pretty. Let me know what your thoughts are. The shimmers look gorgeous. I'm not specifically in the... No, I'm not really in the market for an all shimmer palette. And the reason that I did not order this, even though there is stuff that I really want to get from Glam Shop Poland, which are honestly some older palettes, is basically I have quite a few things that I want to play with and that are new that I have not featured yet on my channel. So that's the reason that I did not pick this up. Let me know if you are excited. Let me know if you have ordered it. Let me know down below. The next thing that I have from them, foils and eye dusts. And they are basically loose pigments. Loose shimmery goodness in shimmery goodness pots. That is what they, and they look pretty as well. Duochromy flaky goodness. Very nice and sparkly and shiny. And they have gorgeous, gorgeous shade. So I will link a Glam Shop Poland down below. What I have tried from them, the quality, it's truly there. So if you are here in Europe, and it's definitely worth it. Definitely. If you are in the USA, I still think it's worth it. But yeah, shipping will be higher. That is the way it is, unfortunately. Let's next go to ColourPop. And I have a few things. So the first thing that I have here is, I think, a picture from a flyer, you know, commercial flyer sheet thing, booklet, whatever. And these are two new palettes from ColourPop for Ulta. You get the Fine Feathered palette and the High Tide palette. They will be available in June at Ulta, and they look pretty, especially the teely one. I like the fact that it is cardboard. Now, if I'm not mistaken, stuff that is basically exclusively to Ulta in the beginning will come to ColourPop site eventually. Is this for me? No, you know, and I kind of like the teely one, but for me to get stuff from ColourPop, I really need to want it for what it is, because it's not something that I have within a few days. Does that make sense? It has to come from overseas. I have to pay import tax, especially after the 20th of June. It will make everything way more expensive, unless ColourPop can kind of do the same as Beauty Bay does and as Makeup Revolution does. Beautylish also has it for us in Europe, that you already pay taxes, so you don't get hit with the taxes behind import taxes later, you know. If they are doing that, then it will make it for me a lot more interesting. But yeah, otherwise, unless they get a reseller here, I really need to want stuff from Colourpop. And I have ordered stuff from Colourpop that I really wanted to get. But this looks pretty. But by the time it gets to Colourpop and then it will get to me, yeah, it's kind of mute. And then it is not interesting enough for me to get. But maybe this is exactly what you are waiting for. The next thing that I have from them is the Your Golden palette. It's also a bigger palette. And yeah, it's not for me. There are shades in here that really draw me in. The teal, the blue, the salmony, peachy pinky one. There are some very, very pretty shades. Now, when I'm looking at the swatches, very pretty shades. But I have this. So for me, it is mute. But maybe it is just what you are waiting for. You know, if you don't have a lot of... Well, I actually think if you don't have a lot of Colourpop palettes, this will be your first palette, or you just have a very, very small collection and you want some pops of color here and there. This could be something for you, you know, but it is not for me. Yeah, and honestly, with what Colourpop is releasing, they are truly duping themselves right now as well with the shades. So, yeah, but that's my opinion. While I love Colourpop, it's just, sometimes it's a little bit too much. You know, on the other hand, I do get kind of withdrawal symptoms if there is a week that I don't talk about Colourpop. So let me know your thoughts on this. Have you gotten this? Is it bombdiggity.com? Let me know your thoughts. Let's next go to basically the European version of Colourpop release-wise, and that is Makeup Revolution. Let's start with this from X Revolution because they have a new launch in that line. They have their bronze collection that get that extra glow this summer. So what do you get? You get a bronze skin cream bronzer in three shades. Cream bronzer. Oh, but that is actually interesting, cream bronzer. So that's the pot. Yes. Then you get a skin glow tinted booster in five shades. Then you get a hydrating lip balm in three shades. An eyeshadow palette, three palettes, and then a high glow face palette, also in two shades. What I'm interested in, the quad that is in here looks gorgeous. Why is this pink though on the outside? I don't know. I don't get the color of the packaging for this line. However, unless they truly reformulated their quads, they are not worth the price in my opinion. I have two quads here. They are not that good. They're not the worst I have, but they're not really that good. And this is a higher priced branch of their organization. So yeah, what I do really like from X Revolution is I love their Hydra. Let me grab it. This one. This is a primer and this is a dead on dupe for the Milk Makeup primer. So if you cannot get that one or you find that one too expensive, this is a dead-on dupe. I actually tested them side by side. There was no difference. So I love that. I also love their highlighter formula and I love the blushes that they have. The bronzer was very, very nice as well. And for the rest, yeah. But I'm very interested in that cream bronzer. Now, unfortunately, I just made a Makeup Revolution order that I will touch on in just a little while. And these were not there because these hadn't launched yet. I also don't know if they have the correct shade for me. So I would like to try it. But I need to see swatches. Preferably, but maybe I will wait until there's a sale because there's a lot of the time a sale going on anyway. But that's what I'm interested in the bronzer. The Shine Hydrating Lip Balm, yeah, I'm kind of interested in as well, but I don't need it, truly. Yeah, what else? I have something else from X Revolution, which are these, which are new eyeshadow palettes. These are the Revolution Flex palettes from Bold and Bright to Natural and Nude. You get a greeny toned one, a hot pink one, an icy blue, fuchsia toned, neutral, warm smoky, bright warm, and a neutral warm toned. When I saw these, I was like, ooh, they look very, very interesting. I did not even notice it was X Revolution. I was thinking about grabbing one, but yeah, I didn't. That's the reason. I didn't. I was in the middle of filming with the BH Cosmetics palettes. And when this launched and I was like, yeah, I don't know when I will be able to film this. If you're really, really interested in this line, in these palettes, let me know and I can pick one up. But I need to see which one though, because in some of the palettes there's only one matte and then the rest are shimmers. So yeah, let me know your thoughts. Do I know what the retail for is? Does that say? Yeah, the palettes aren't very expensive though. They are £8, €10 or €9. So let me know if you would want me to try the formula, because I can. I just don't know when I will be able to though, because what is coming my way is this. Sof has collaborated with Makeup Revolution for the third time. Now, I have not tried her first collab. However, I did try her second one, the Extra Spice palette. I have it here. I did not try her highlighter palette, but I did try the eyeshadow formula and I tried the lipsticks. The quality was amazing, truly. And the Extra Spice is one of my favorite palettes that I have in my collection. I don't use it anymore because it's pretty old and it kind of smells funky. But like me, sometimes. Never mind. But I still have it and I still have it for a reason. And when they kind of announced round three, I was going to talk about it anyway. Now, then Angelica mentioned, she said to me, "Have you seen it yet?" And I was immediately on Instagram for the pictures. And then I was on the Makeup Revolution site to order. What did I order? I ordered the big palette. I was looking at the small palette, but now that I see them side by side, basically the small palette is a very, very curated version of the bigger palette. What I did notice though is two things. First off, the palettes are cardboard and it looks like they are magnetic. I'm not sure, but that is what it looked like to me. So, yeah, I cannot wait to get the big palette. And they had a sale going on as well, so I ordered a few more things. So I got the big palette. I also got two of the face palettes. Because one was, I got the darkest face palette because it was called Honey something. What was it called again? Honey Glaze. And I was like, I need it. It could very well be that it is too dark for me, but I thought that that orange shade I could use as a blush topper, you know. And I also got the Cookies and Cream face duo because looking at the shades, that would be the best highlighting wise, and I just wanted it. I don't know why. And I got the two lip sets. So basically you get a narrow lip stylo, like the lippy sticks from ColourPop, you know, that format, and then two corresponding lip pencils. But the colors, I was like, yeah. So basically the toffee drizzle lip kit is a toffee color, and then the candy icing lip kit was, I think, more of a peachy color, and I was like, oh yes please, yes please. Let me give you prices. So the Super Spice shadow palette, say that 10 times fast, is $18. The mini palette is 10. The face duos are 10 each, and there are three shades, so for basically light, medium, and deep or dark. Then the lip kits are 10, and I think that they also brought back the lipsticks from her second launch, but just two shades, the shade Syrup and Fudge. And I think, and the other, what was the other one? Because there were three, that you had a pinky nude, you had a basically a caramelly one, and then a darker one. And I had all three. I did declutter them because they had kind of melted here because it was so warm in my filming room. So I threw them out. And I was actually thinking of picking them back up again because the formula is truly, truly nice. But I have the colors. And especially with the other two, I was like, yeah, I don't, let's not do that. So yeah, that is what I got. And I'm very, very excited. I think it's just so cool that Sof got to collab with them again. And looking at this is right up my alley. You know, you get, is it half colorful, half neutral? Well, maybe. I see four browns and the rest are color. You know, so I'm very, very happy. I cannot wait to get this. And I remember when I got her first, or my first real palette from Makeup Revolution, this one. I did five looks. I did one look per video, basically. So I did five videos as well. I can do, if you guys are interested, I can do multiple looks with this one as well. Let me know down below. I'm very, very interested to receive this and I hope I will get it soon. I got some other things as well that I wanted to get from Makeup Revolution. So yeah, let me know if you're excited. The next thing from Makeup Revolution that is also coming my way is this from Revolution Pro. This is the cream skin perfector, and it has shade adapting technology. It's magic in a tube. So basically they have 5 colors. You get a light, medium, a tan, a dark and a deep. And basically it covers a shade range. So the light covers the shades 0.1, 0.2, 0.5 or 1. So very, very light. And then the medium is 2.5, 3.5 or 5.7. So that's the one that I got because of the oliveness, you know. And then the tan is for shades 6.5, 8, 9 or 10. So I could even have gone that route. Then the dark is for 11.2, 11.5, 13 or 14.7, and then the deep for 16, 16.5, 17.5 or 18. I also saw swatches somewhere, but yeah, I picked up the medium one, which is probably a little bit too light for me even, but we will see. I'm waiting for it. I ordered it from Beauty Bay. Because there were some other things that I wanted and it hadn't come to Boozy Shop yet. So I'm waiting for this one and I'm very, very curious about this. Because if this works, yeah, that would be amazing, right? So I'm very, very curious. So when I have it, you bet your bottoms that I'm going to do a dedicated video on it. Because I'm very, very interested in this product. Okay, let me know if you are as well. Let me know if you've ordered it. Yes. Next is from Beauty Bay, because I think that it's launching today. It's their summer collection and it is called Utopia. You get an eyeshadow palette, which contains 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 8. Wow. Was this an all matte palette? I don't remember if this was an all matte palette or not. And then the other 5 pen palette are water activated liners, if I am not mistaken. Then you get 3, I don't know, or 4 glitter pots or something. And 3 lip glosses? Oh, 4 pigment pots, yes, and a lip gloss trio. It's dropping today. I don't exactly know what time it is dropping. Could be that it is live already. I think this is a fun color story. Very, very fun. Now, I was kind of thinking of picking it up. No, I don't think I have. And the reason is basically I have quite a few things that I'm waiting on. I don't know when I would have the time. And this is also a limited edition collection. I don't think that I can do it justice. That is what I think. That I cannot do it justice. So I am probably going to pass. But you never know with me. I do like their formula though. Just saying. I do like their formula. But I don't think that I will order this, because again, there is quite a lot of... I'm also waiting on the Lethal. Oh yeah, did we talk about that? We didn't, right? Because it was shown... Or did I talk about that? I did mention it last week, yeah. But what I actually... What I ordered... Let me tell you what I ordered. I ordered the Rites palette, which was the one with the yellow. I will put a picture up. I ordered the Momento palette, which was the one with the peachy... orangey. I ordered 2 lipsticks. I ordered a lip gloss and I ordered a face palette that I created with some shades in it. Yes, that was kind of, yeah, it happens. But yeah, so I have quite enough. I don't have time to review this, so that's why I am going to let this one go, I think. Yes. Okie dokie, let's go next to Sigma, because Sigma is doing some collabs. So let's start with this. This was announced last week when was this announced? I don't exactly know, but I will link her video down below, because it's a collaboration between Sigma and Jen from Jen Loves Reviews, or Jen Loves, I think it is right now. They did a favorites brush set. I don't know if it is still in stock. Maybe it is sold out, but I still wanted to mention it. And I think that the brushes that she put in there, they're also some of my favorite brushes from Sigma. I think she did an amazing job. And I'm so, so very happy. So congratulations, Jen, on this amazing collab. Yeah, let me tell you a little bit about it. So basically, there are brushes, 3 brushes, and the Untamed eyeshadow palette. And then the brush that is included in that. Now, I really like the color story of the Untamed palette. For me, to get... It's mute. That is it. If I am getting an eyeshadow palette from Sigma, it's one of the 9 pan palettes. I know which one I still want to get. It's the one with the goldeny one, so the most neutral one. I haven't. Maybe I will one day, but I haven't. But the brushes that are in her set are the E27, the E33 and the E65. Now, I don't have the E65, but that's the precision line. That's the liner brush, right? Do I have a picture of the liner brush? Yeah, it's a liner brush. I have liner brushes, and then the I need to clean that one. And I have the E33? Yeah. So the other two brushes are these that I have here. This is the E27. Was it in it? Yeah. And this is the E33. Now this one is a little bit too stiff for what I like, but this one I use a Krypton. I need to wash it. Can you tell? I really like this brush. I like Sigma brushes. That's it. I like Sigma brushes. And I think that she curated this perfectly. So yeah, congratulations to Jen. And let me know if you are excited. Let me know if you have picked up the set. Let me know down below. And the next thing that they are collaborating with is It Gets Better. And I think that's an organization. So it's It Gets Better project. It's a non-profit organization. It is connecting LGBTQ+ youth. And they have been doing that for over 10 years through storytelling, education and building a global community. So that is the collab for Pride. And it is a new 3-piece Pride brush set and bag. It will be available for June the 2nd. And 50% of proceeds from that set will be donated to the It Gets Better project. Why do I want to say it's? I don't know. But let me know your thoughts down below. Okay, next is a collaboration between Be Perfect and Jack Yosha. It's chapter 2. It's the Glow Goddess palette. It is a timeless collection of her favorite 12 shades, rich warm tones and beautiful glowing shimmers that makes it super easy to recreate her signature glam. It includes 3 shimmers, 9 high pigment and easy to blend mattes. It retails for 25 British pounds. The general sale is today at 10 a.m. and I think it is 10 a.m. Central European Standard Time. Or is it 10 a.m. UK time? I don't know actually. Oh, here I have the time. The total availability is 4 a.m. CST. I hope that helps. And if you are... Oh, she's called Jacqueline Osborne. I did not know that. Jacqueline Osborne. And the palette will retail for around $35. So let me know if you're excited. The color story looks pretty. Yeah, soft glam. Yeah, it's not for me, but it does look very, very pretty. Let me know if you are excited. Okay, let's next go to Pout and Shout because she is doing stuff again. She's busy. There is one product reserved, which you will see here, which is the one with the nose. It's a finishing powder that it's reserved, so I don't know, maybe it is sold already. So let's go on to the next one then, which are some highlighters. And she has done a bunch of new highlighters. And she is also she has also done a lipstick palette. Let's see. The Happy Glow Lucky highlighters. The Lucky Bridal Bouquet is highlighter / eyeshadow, high shimmer, slightly blushed ivory base with a sprinkling of baby blue sparkly bits, vegan handmade and housed in professionally sanitized upcycled outer packaging. And it is DM to order on Instagram, so I'll leave her Instagram down below. She also had some other colors, I believe. Let's see. You also get a Lucky Blue Moon. It's a foiled periwinkle blue. And the other one was with a greenie, I think. The Happy Glow Lucky Highlighter in Lucky Dandelion. Super sparkly silvery shades with notes of icy blue and green. So those are the highlighters. I will leave them down. I will leave her Instagram handle down below. Go check her out. I have a blush and... Well, I basically have 2 blushes. Honestly. Because the bronzer shade for me is also more of a blush than a bronzer. But go check her out because she is just amazeballs. Let's go to... This. When I first saw this, I was like, oh, is Kasia Beauty doing now more things? But no, it is not. It's Morphe. And I did not see this one coming. So, yeah, I don't really know what to make of this. On the one hand, I'm like, I kind of like this because I like the format. On the other hand, I'm like, I don't know if I like this. Then I do like one of the colors though, which is the one with the orangey and the peachy. But for the rest, yeah, I don't really know what to make of this. What do you think? They are available at Morphe's site for $16 each. There's a kitty cat playing, so I hope my stuff doesn't fall over. Let me know. What else do I have? Let's see. Let's go to this from Nomad, because they are dropping a new palette in a few weeks and they are giving you guesses again. So it says here, this new palette will be an umbrella destination, meaning each shade is a unique place on their own, but they all collectively come together to create the one umbrella destination, a little bit like their Antilles palette that had different islands from the Caribbean representing each shade. Let's see, we are going to reveal the new launch and the countdown a bit differently. They will have three shade reveals and then the final umbrella destination reveal as they launch, and this will give you the chance to place a guess four different times to win the new palette. So I will leave their Instagram down below, go check them out and leave your guess. The palette will be shown June the 7th and it will launch June the 8th. And I don't know if it is currently on its way already, but I know I'm getting this in PR and I cannot wait. I cannot wait to see what they are coming out with right now. I cannot wait to see the color story. I'm just so excited. I'm so excited and I cannot wait to see it. So yeah, when I have pictures, I will show you. I think so. It says here, over 11 films have used this destination for scenes in their movies, including Thelma and Louise and Indiana Jones and The Last Crusade. It's clue one of three. And they will ask for final answers on clue three. So you have a little time to guess. I don't know. Red Rock? I don't know. I truly don't know. But yeah, maybe you do. Leave your guesses down below. I have no idea. Truly, I have no idea. But I do know that I'm getting this palette. I do have a discount code with Nomad in case you want to use it. And it's all very, very exciting. Yes. What else do I have? Oh, yes. I have this. This is a new brand. It's called Chaos Dirt. And they have just launched with Sparkly Goodness. It's a very small brand. Yeah, they have just launched. I will leave the Instagram down below. Do they have a website? Yeah, they also have a website. Go check out their Instagram because they have swatches of all the Sparkly Goodness. You see the shadows here, but they have swatches of all the Sparkly Goodness shadows. So, yeah, very, very pretty. Very pretty, very new brand. Let me know if you know the brand. I am not really into singles. I have some, but it's usually I go for a bundle or for a pre-made palette because that's just easier for me because I have a channel. It's just easier. But they look very, very, very pretty. Truly, yes. Okay, let's see. What else do I have? Oh yeah, I have this from Huda Beauty. They are launching a new sister brand called Glow Wish. And Glow Wish is multitasking makeup with skin benefits. That's basically very popular right now, isn't it? It's not new though. A lot of brands have done that. Think for instance of the It's CC cream with all the goodness there, you know. So it's not new, but it is kind of on trend, I feel at least. It's vegan, so I like that. And it's never been tested on animals, which is good as well. Obviously, because I'm a cruelty-free channel. It's sustainable packaging and ingredients. The cartons are 100% recyclable. You've got skin-loving ingredients and 90% is naturally derived. Yeah. That is such a gimmick, because almost anything is naturally derived, if you think about it. But yeah, so I never find those claims, they don't do anything for me. It says here though, a multi-dew skin tint gives you that effortless weekend glow. The moisturizing formula is lightly tinted with the perfect level of pearl to blur and brighten. I don't know if it is then specifically for me. But okay, you have 13 super stretchable shades. Maybe they contain lycra. You know, because that makes your clothing stretch. I don't know. I was trying to be funny. Never mind. waterproof and transferproof. Now that is interesting. Is it sweatproof then? I don't think so, but because usually it's not. But that's okay. It's now this I like. It's fragrance free. Now that I like. Yes, packed full of skin loving ingredients like ugly red pepper extract, Damascus rose oil and squalane. I love squalane as well. What else do you get? A soft radiance bronzing powder, smoothest, most creamy formula that effortlessly adds warmth and dimension. 5 shades, lasts up to 12 hours, it's buildable and gives a blurring effect. Packed full of shea butter, vitamin E, squalane, that ugly bell pepper again, and then Damascus rose oil. It launches the 1st of June on Huda Beauty Shop. I cannot wait to see reviews on this. It does sound very, very interesting. Let me know your thoughts down below. What else? Oh yeah. I'm going to show you 2 things. It's kind of the same product, but one thing I don't find interesting at all, and the other one I think is hilarious. So let's start with the thing that I... Let's start with this. Can you guess which one of the two it is? This is from Beauty Blender, and they have a new color. The Aquamarine. It's available now for $20 and it is limited edition. If you have a beauty room that is geared in specific colors, I can see this appealing to someone. But yeah, not to me. I don't care truly what color my sponge is. And can I just tell you, I have tried Beauty Blender. It's not my... I think they are very overhyped. Yeah, you want to know my favorite sponges? These from Shop Miss A, the pawpaw sponges. I actually just bought 2 packs. I got them in today, but I love these sponges. I love them, and I don't use. I have 2 in use right now, and they actually last for quite some time. Now I know that you should throw them away after, I don't know, 3 months or something. But you know what I do? I deep clean them in the washing machine every week. So, I don't know, you know, and then they're clean. So, yeah, I don't... You know when I throw my sponges away, if they smell weird or if they break up, that's when I throw them out. But overall, yeah, these will last me quite some time. They are, what are they? I think $6 for a pack of that. Yeah, they are amazeballs. And this is the original one. They are truly amazing. You don't need Beauty Blender. If you want something like that, get the ones from Shop Miss A. Just my 2 cents. But what I also have are these. And these I find amazeballs. It's a small brand. Yeah, they're not that big. Hex Baby Beauty. And they are the scream sponges. This I love. Yeah, they're retail for $5, which is a very, very nice price. The reason I don't order this is because it has to ship from America. And then it is, you know, basically shipping starts for smaller brands. I think shipping to me starts at, what is it, $20? Something like that. Yeah, that's just, I like it, but not enough for that. You know, so... But I really, really like this and I wanted to mention it. And she has got an already overwhelming response. Go order, because they are just amazeballs. They are just so, so cool. You know, this I would, I don't know, this I would put on display because it makes me happy to look at. Yeah, so maybe if Beauty Blender would do something funky like that. You know what I did like from Beauty, was that Beauty Blender who came out with SpongeBob? Was that Beauty Blender? I think they were, right? Was that last year? Now that I, because that is genius, you know? That I like. But yeah, an aqua blue, a baby blue beauty blender. Yeah, no, not so much. So let's go to the last thing that I have here, which is from... Yeah, I cannot afford this, but it is so, so pretty. It's from Pat McGrath. It is online already. It is the Divine Blush Collection. It looks so, so... It looks stunning. It truly looks stunning. I would love to try one of her blushes. I would also love to try her eyeshadow. But I am not going to pay that, right? That's what I'm saying right now. You know, I'm not going to pay that for an eyeshadow. I'm just not. I do hope though that I am one day somewhere where I'm like, yeah, I'm going to buy a Pat McGrath eyeshadow palette. Because that means that my channel is as successful as I want it to be. So yeah, but yeah, these are blushes and lippies. Highlighter, a quad. There are no prices here for which I'm grateful. I don't want to know what this goes for. But it's so stunning. Not specifically the lipsticks. I'm not really interested in the lipsticks, but the blushes. Oh. They look gorgeous. Yeah, I would love to try something like that someday. Truly, but yeah, it is not that day right now. So yeah, that was it for my finds of this week. I am still here on the site because I want to give a special shout out to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. And it is almost time for a members only video, which if all goes to plan will be uploaded the 1st of June. And it is going to be about color theory. I don't exactly know how I will do everything, but basically color theory. And I am I love playing with color theory and such. I love that. So if you want to know how I do that and my thoughts on it and my tips and tricks, then make sure that you are a member, and it will go online, if all goes well, the 1st of June. There's also a members only playlist, and if you are a member, you have access to all the videos on that playlist, because I only have one membership tier to make it easier on myself. You also get a special raven emoji behind your name in the comment section and in live chats you also, and you get special emojis to use in the comment section and in live chat if you are a member. And then that is it for today. Yes, thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you tomorrow. So tomorrow it's looking like a snack from BH Cosmetics, this one. And then the day after, so Sunday, it is the Loki Love You palette, and that's what this one looks like. And then it is back to the regular programming for Monday. So it's going to be a full week. Yeah, that was it. Thank you so much, guys. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye.